5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. It would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice in its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister looking. The look it was giving me.
What are you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better... Sir? See ya!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show. Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight, Friday night. Thank God. The week's almost over with. What a week. What a week I've had. I got to tell you guys, the server's been down. I was down yesterday trying to move to a bigger server for more of the workload on the site. So hopefully you'll notice the site's moving a little bit faster. I know some of the things got lost yesterday. Like, for instance, some of the blog posts got lost. I know some things in the forum got lost in transition. So anything posted late the 23rd is probably not there. So I didn't delete your forum posts. If you guys are wondering, I know some people are emailing me asking me if I'm going in and deleting their forum post. I'm not deleting it. It was a transition from moving it to another server. So hopefully with the upgrade, the site will run a little bit faster and a little bit smoother for you guys. Remember, if you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. And you can follow me on Twitter at SasquatchCron. Send me a message. I try to respond to as many as I can. Feel free to shoot me a message on there as well as shoot me an email. If you've had an encounter, though, please email me. It's an easier way for me to contact you. And when you send me your email, please include your phone number. It just cuts down on the back and forth of me trying to find a way to contact you. Welcome to the show, guys. I really appreciate you guys being here tonight. On Sunday, I got a couple guests lined up, a couple exciting things. I know one of my guests on Sunday opened the curtains and went to open her door, and there was a Sasquatch standing there reaching down to open the door, and they got face to face, and she screamed, the Sasquatch screamed, and then they parted ways. That'll be one of my guests. I'll also be retelling the William Rose story. Here's a small clip from it. I had just come out of a patch of low brush into this clearing when I saw what I thought was a grizzly bear. I had shot a grizzly bear in the exact same spot a year prior. This one was only about 75 yards away, but I didn't want to shoot it because I had no way of getting it out. So I sat down on a small rock and watched with my rifle in my hands. I could see part of the animal's head and top of one shoulder. A moment later, it raised up and stepped out into the opening. Then I saw this was no bear. So look for that on Sunday night. Should be a fun night. Well, let's get into it tonight. Imagine buying a vacation cabin, a peaceful place for you and your family to go hang out, until you start noticing strange creatures around your property. They scream, they make monkey noises, they slap the home, and you're not really sure what to do. That's what happened to my first guest tonight. I want to get into it tonight. Andrew, thanks for coming on the show, man. I really appreciate you being here tonight.
Hey, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. And I know when you and I talked the other day, you know, you had a lot of interesting things going on and around your cabin. For the audience, if you would kind of start from the beginning. Tell us about the cabin. Tell us about the first time you experienced anything. And then just kind of walk us into the ongoing activity that you've experienced going on there.
Sure. That's a little background on the cabin. It's just a vacation lake house we have, you know, several hours from where we live. It's on a big lake here in Alabama. You know, the house is directly facing the lake. The lake runs probably, you know, 15 yards from the front of the house. Surrounded by woods, pretty much on all three sides except for the lakefront. Right behind the house, there's kind of a big hardwood bottom and kind of goes up on a ridge. And then a bunch of pine thickets behind that and all around. It's a very, very secluded area. You know, there are houses around, but the one next door is actually completely vacant. And the other houses on the road, people just come and go during the summer. There's no, you know, not a lot of activity in the winter or even in the summer during the week for that matter.
When did the activity start? Was it when you very first moved in?
No, we've been at this location for 12 years in this house. We actually had another house on the street three doors down prior to that. So we've been, you know, on this road at this location for probably around 20 years and never experienced anything until October of last year. I believe it was October 21st or 22nd. It was a Sunday. My wife and my son, they were probably at the beach or Disney World or something like that. And that Monday was a holiday. So I had just, you know, taken our family dog and I'd gone down there just to, you know, go try to fish, just relax, just kind of get away from things. The first night I was there, nothing happened. It was just very calm and peaceful. It was a very nice weekend. Yeah, not a cloud in the sky, no wind, no sound, no anything. It was wonderful. But the second night, I had gone fishing just on our pier in front of the house for a couple of hours until about 9:30 p.m. Nothing of note. Then I was back up on our front porch, and we have a big, long front porch on the front of the house with a bunch of rocking chairs, patio furniture over on the side. And so I was just sitting there playing music, you know, not loud, but, you know, kind of quiet and just relaxing, sitting there with this dog. And it was about 10:30. And so I went to go take her for a walk before I wrap things up for the night. So I put her on the leash, walked out of the front of the house on the lakeside, and then walked around the side of the house through the grass. We have a big gravel driveway in the back. And I was kind of parallel with or perpendicular to the back door, just in the gravel driveway. And it's surrounded by woods, you know, just a few yards away from the driveway. So it's very wooded. And we were walking back there, and then I heard just what sounded like a deer blow. You know, I've been hunting all my life, and I've heard that sound 1,000 times. So I heard a deer blow, and then I heard something you know, run off over towards the our vacant neighbor's house. So, you know, didn't think too much of it. But then immediately after, I heard this distinct but light wood knock, just wood on wood. You know, I kind of laughed. I'd watched, you know, Finding Bigfoot and all that stuff, and it was pretty comical to me. So I jokingly just whooped over in that direction. And, you know, immediately following, I heard a massive wood knock from behind me in the woods on the other side of the driveway. So, you know, that freaked me out a little bit. And I didn't do anything else. I just immediately, you know, grabbed the dog. And then we just kind of retraced our steps around the side of the house and just went back up to the porch. And so we sat there just maybe for a minute or two. And then over, I guess to my right, I was facing the lake. We have a utility shed where we keep lawnmowers and stuff like that. And there's a little small patch of wood behind it.